Passing inspection, we decided to give our block a coat of Chevy orange paint.
We're ready to begin machining the block right now, and our first operation is going to be the line honing procedure on the main bearing saddles here. Now, it does a couple of things. First of all, it's going to give us the proper bearing crush. It's also going to allow us to control oil pressure to the engine a lot more accurately. Most importantly, though, it's going to establish this crank center line here. Now, all of our subsequent machining operations are going to be based on that center line. Real important stuff.
Because of the longer stroke in our 383, the bottom of the bore needs some notching with a die grinder. This will give the rods plenty of clearance. Then, before boring, we need to measure our new pistons with a micrometer. We want to make sure that we don't overbore. Then, the cylinder walls are bored perpendicular to the center line of the crank. This CNC machine is set at 30 thousandths, leaving 3 to 5 thousandths for the final hone. Then we zero-deck the surface of our block parallel to the crank center line, taking off just the required material. Honing the cylinder walls is next, but first, the machinist will bolt on a torque plate. Now this will pre-stress the block so that the cylinder walls stay round. Honing gives the walls a cross-hatch finish to allow proper oil travel to the upper part of the cylinder area.
In the meantime, we're about ready to balance our summit crankshaft. Now, they've already attached all the bob weights, but before we can spin it up, well, we've got to bolt on this PCI flex plate and the Rattler dampener so we can spin it up and balance everything as a rotating assembly.
With all the machining completed, our block gets a bath in this anti-corrosive liquid. Brass freeze-out plugs are knocked in place. Cam bearings are installed, and at last, it's ready for our 383 stroker builder. All right, here it is. Now, in any performance buildup, the machine work is probably even more important than all those parts that we're going to bolt into it, because let's face it, if this thing comes apart on us on our first pass, well, all those expensive parts just become expensive junk.
Good point. It may cost more to do it right, but it's money well spent. Well, we're about ready to kick off this stroker project, and we'll attack the bottom end right after this.
Later in the show, some hot rod time travel as we look at the heroes and highlights of 50 years of Hot Rod Magazine. Build serious horsepower and torque. Turn your PC into an engine dyno with Mr. Gasket's Desktop Dyno software. With ease, Desktop Dyno lets you design and evaluate any engine. From single cylinders up to 1,000 cubic inch V10s. Evaluate cams, valves, compression ratios, and performance heads. With accurate on-screen horsepower and torque curves. It's $50 software that lets you test your next engine before you build it. Desktop Dyno from the Mr. Gasket Performance Group. Call for your local dealer.
What do women look for in a man?
A guy who sends me flowers. For no reason at all.
At work.
Yeah.
A man who knows what a woman wants.
A guy who watches football with the sound off.
A man who reads Men's Health, America's number one men's magazine. From cover to cover, Men's Health gives you inside information to get the edge you need and keep it.
A guy who can, well, you know.
Yeah, I know.
Sculpt amazing abs. Beat stress before it beats you. Learn which vitamins men need for maximum energy and what women wish men knew about sex. Call now for your free trial issue. Keep it and get 1 year of Men's Health for only $19.97. You'll also get our Peak Performance gift set free, featuring quick and healthy cooking for men, 100 ways to burn fat faster, and the guide to ultimate intimacy.
A man who knows just how to touch.
Get the edge. Order the magazine the others want to be. Men's Health, the magazine men live by. Call now.
A slow 5 minute kiss, Joey.
Welcome to Psychic Talk USA.
Have you given any ideas to going into business for yourself?
Yes, how did you know that? Yes.
She's a psychic.
Try our amazing psychics yourself with our best offer ever. Let our real psychics convince you. Don't miss this incredible opportunity. Call right now.
Now, is she modeling or you? Because I keep feeling there's a modeling.
Oh, you are so good.
Try it yourself. We're making our best offer ever to prove to you that our psychics are real. So call right now.
Call 1-800-329-9763.
Hot Rod TV is brought to you by Husky, the toughest name in tools, available only at the Home Depot. And by Wyoming Tech, training tomorrow's technicians today.
All right, welcome back to the Hot Rod Shop and to our stroker buildup. You know, the 383 has become a reliable, proven combination for hot rodders, and it's popular for good reason because we get an extra 33 cubic inches from a stock 350 by adding a 400 crank.
Now, that stock 350 crank specs out at about 3.48 inches, while the 400 crank measures 3.75 inches. Now, that's going to give us an extra quarter inch, or a little bit more than a quarter inch, of extra piston travel up and down the cylinder bore. Going to give us some extra displacement and some more horsepower. But where it's really going to make a difference is in that all-important tire-twisting torque department.
You bet.
Now, what we're going to use here for a crank is Summit's ProLine 4340 steel crank. After all, we're probably going to be looking at 450 horsepower with this buildup, and we can use all the strength that we can get on that bottom end. Now, to be sure, this thing's going to be a lot stronger than that stock cast iron piece.
That it is. Let me show you something here. You saw this thing at the machine shop earlier. Well, here's some places where material was taken away from the crank to bring it fully into balance. Now, this thing comes right out of the box with fully chamfered oil hose to lubricate those bearings, as well as radius fillets. Now, check this out. These are micro-polished journals. Nice piece, Chuck.
It really is. Now, that crank's going to have a good home. It's going to be riding on these special Federal Mogul main and rod bearings. Now, the upper halves of those bearings have a special groove in them to facilitate oiling on the crankshaft, but here's the real trick. The special finish here is going to improve the bearing-to-crank contact area. It's going to improve the heat transfer, more reliability.
Okay, you got that last bearing snapped in there, Chuck?
I sure do. Let me go get that crank.
All right. Of course, we're putting a coat of fresh oil on these things, rubbing around real good, and now we're ready for that crank, Chuck. You got it?
You bet. Now, you want to line this thing up before you drop it in, and you drop it straight down because the last thing you want to do is nick any of those crank journals on those studs. There it is. We're ready for those main caps.
When you put these caps back on, make sure these little arrows point forward, and you torque them down about 65 to 70 foot-pounds.
Next, we'll install our piston and rod assemblies. Now, the Summit 383 kit that we're using comes with these SpeedPro hyper-eutectic pistons. They're a very affordable alternative to forged pistons, but they're a whole lot stronger than the cast pieces. To seal the cylinders, well, we're going to use a set of sealed power Molly rings. In fact, I'll tell you what, I'm going to start getting these rings on these pistons right now.
Good deal. Now, we've hung our pistons on a set of these Summit ProLine steel rods. Check out this comparison. Here's a stock rod, and here's one of ours. See how much bigger the beams are, and there's a lot more material here in the big end. Plus, these ARP cap screws and the small ends have been bushed for floating pins.
Now, once the rings are installed, we lubricate them liberally with some engine oil, and we can go ahead and install the ring compressor and these rod bolt boots. Now, these boots are real important. They're going to keep us from dinging that crank once we start sliding this piston assembly home. Then, we tap them into the bores using this powerhouse piston knocker. Make sure to guide the bolts, though, so that they straddle the rod journal.
Well, now we're ready to install the rod caps. We'll torque the bolts once all the pistons are in place.
All right, that ought to get it. Now, we're torquing our rod bolts to 60 foot-pounds, and we'll be back with our camshaft installation right after this.
If working on cars and trucks is your calling, you should call this number now. Wyoming Tech, where a few months of specialized training prepares you for the career of a lifetime. Wyoming Tech has the experienced faculty and state-of-the-art equipment you need to build skills in automotive tech, diesel technology, collision and refinishing, even street rod building and auto customizing. Call now for your free information kit from Wyoming Tech and turn your passion into a profession. The hum of the saw, the wail of the drill, the rhythm of the plane. If you love the music of woodworking, listen to this free CD offer. It's 101 shop tips, packed with secrets from the pros like a jig for routing evenly spaced dados, straightening uneven edges. You'll get 101 time-saving tips, and you get it free when you order cabinet making for just $9.99. Packed with hundreds of full-color photos and illustrations, cabinet making shows you how to master every cabinetry technique and get picture-perfect results.
Preview future volumes from The Art of Woodworking with no commitment to buy. Use your credit card and get this video, Shop Secrets from Master Craftsmen, free. So call now to order cabinet making for just $9.99 and get 101 shop tips free. Use your credit card and get your free Shop Secrets video. Call now.
Call 1-800-935-7272 to order cabinet making and get your free 101 shop tips. Use your credit card and receive a free Shop Secrets video, or send check or money order to the address on your screen.
Friday night on TNN, Motor Madness. They ride and they roll. They're the biggest, the meanest machines in motorsports. They're monster trucks, and they'll be taking Iowa by storm. Plus more hard charging, high flying, full arena truck action. It's another USA Motorsports Monster Truck Challenge on TNN Motor Madness. This Friday night at 8 Eastern, 5 Pacific, and it's all on the Nashville Network.
Hot Rod TV is brought to you by the Eastwood Company, unique automotive tools and supplies, and by Edelbrock, the most powerful name in performance.
Hi, welcome back to the Hot Rod Shop. As you probably know, the camshaft is like the brains of any engine. It determines when, where, and, well, to an extent, how much power your engine makes. Now, with our horsepower goals, we need a fairly aggressive cam, so we chose this hydraulic flat tappet piece from Competition Cam.
Now, this particular piece specs out at 240 degrees intake and 246 degrees on the exhaust side. Of course, that's measured at 50 thousandths valve lift. Now, the rest of our cam kit came with a double roller timing chain set and a set of hydraulic lifters. Now, we're going to take you through a procedure today that's very, very important for any high-performance engine buildup. We're going to show you how to degree this camshaft using some special tools and instruments from Powerhouse Products. But before we can get going, well, I've got to throw this thing in the block.
Good deal. Now, here are the tools you'll need. A degree wheel like this, piston bridge with a dial indicator, a piston stop, a magnetic base with a dial indicator. Oh, and you'll need to fab up some sort of pointer. We made ours with this piece of coat hanger.
When you install the camshaft, make sure that you use the lube that comes with the kit. Then we'll be ready to install our timing set. Now, we're going to install ours straight up to begin with.
Degreeing the cam is an essential part of the blueprinting process that should only take you about a half hour. Got that chain on?
It's on there. Now we're ready for the degree wheel. It just slides on the crank snout like that.
And we'll put our pointer right up here.
Then install the stop on the number one cylinder.
Now rotate the engine clockwise till the piston hits the stop, then write down the number that's on the wheel. Then turn the engine counterclockwise till the piston hits the stop and record that number.
Of course, you just add those two numbers together, divide them in half, and that'll give you a true top dead center. What do you got there, Joe?
About 23 and a half. Now we're ready to center line the cam.
But before we do, we have to move the wheel to 23 and a half degrees. Drop a dummy lifter into the number one intake lifter bore and use the edge of it here as a pickup point for your dial indicator. Rotate the engine until you see zero lift, then keep on rotating until you see 50 thousandths lift. Write down the number that's on the wheel. We kept rotating past maximum lift until we found 50 thousandths on the closing side.
And if the numbers match those on the manufacturer's card, then the cam's properly phased in and we're on the money.
Looks like it to me.
We'll button up the bottom end of our stroker today with a new oil pump. Now, this is a Speed Pro high volume pump that'll get plenty of fresh oil to all those components. Now, it's been fitted with a Mylodon pickup that's specially engineered to work with our new oil pan.
Yeah, but before we bolt that oil pan in place, well, we're going to go ahead and cinch down this windage tray to those special studs that we attach to the mains. Now, that windage tray is going to keep the oil from wrapping itself around the crankshaft and becoming a parasitic power loss. Now, the oil pan itself is a special 7-quart unit, and we get that extra capacity from the kickouts on the side here. That way, we don't have to deepen the sump and lose our ground clearance.
While we finish up, you stay right there. We'll have a special look back at 50 years of hot rodding coming right up.
I'm Vic Edelbrock, and I want to show you the greatest breakthrough in technology I've ever seen.
Edelbrock's revolutionary new Performer IAS shocks are unlike anything on the road, providing maximum handling, comfort, and stability. Our patented inertia active system instantly adjusts for the ultimate ride, sports car performance, and luxury car comfort. For more on Edelbrock shocks, call 1-800-FUN-TEAM for a free Edelbrock catalog.
You'll feel the difference with Edelbrock shocks, or I'll give you your money back. You've got my word on it.
Can your radio do this? Only one radio can give you stereo sound this big, yet is small enough to fit almost anywhere. The extraordinary new Wave radio from Bose. Press the remote control and hear sound from a radio like you've never heard before. Big, rich sound that fills the room. You hear music the way it was meant to be heard. Clear, full, incredibly lifelike. You've got to hear the Wave radio to believe it, and now you can in your own home. Satisfaction guaranteed. Call us toll-free to learn how, and we'll deliver the Wave radio to your door. Experience big stereo sound from a radio. Call today for more information. It will make a difference in the way you listen to music. A big difference.
Monday.
Walk on the wild side of the Ryman with Ricky Skaggs and this week's guests, Bruce Hornsby.
Musically, he lives on the edge.
I always thought music was about listening and playing off of people.
Plus, Bela Fleck.
He really takes the banjo and makes it such an enjoyable listening instrument. He's absolutely brilliant.
And Vince Gill.
I think as much as I love bluegrass, I think I had a different direction in mind.
Monday night concerts, 10 Eastern, 7 Pacific on TNN.
Hot Rod TV is brought to you by the Home Depot, your exclusive source for Husky tools, and by Mr. Gasket Company, America's leading supplier of performance parts.
Man, this thing looks like it means business already. You know, this year marks a special milestone for millions of gearheads around the world. You see, it was January 1948 that the first issue of Hot Rod hit the streets, a magazine that would shape the future of hot rodding for the next 50 years.
There was something magic and momentous going on here in the dry lakes of post-war Southern California. Renegade racers with modified machines sharing a growing passion for high performance. A lifestyle they called hot rodding. A craze that captured the eye of a young entrepreneur.
We did the first Hot Rod show in 1948, January. And that was the same time as the first issue of Hot Rod magazine.
Strangely enough, when Pete came to sell me an ad in the first issue, I said, you know, I'm going to wait and see how this thing does.
I remember in 1947 when Bob Peterson was coming to my dad's little garage. And in fact, Bob didn't have a car. He had to hitchhike. And he was picking up a piece to take back for his parts with a peel pay.
Under editor Wally Parks, Hot Rod became the national voice of a new sport, sharing speed secrets for the home garage, promoting safety on the hometown strip. Hot Rod was there for coverage of the first national drag championships in 1955. Hot Rod was at Barnabas when Mickey Thompson became the fastest man on earth.
Little GTO, you really look at time.
By the 60s, Detroit had become a believer, too, with its muscle cars, and Hot Rod had them. But it was always a magazine for and by Hot Rodders, like the young racer who joined the staff back in 68.
Hot Rod is my life. Hot Rod would have been my life. So I guess I'm one of the luckiest individuals alive.
For five decades, Hot Rods reported just about everything in the world of high performance. From bikes to boats, from go-karts to vans. Bringing the aftermarket to life with its how-to tech. Introducing us to heroes like Garland and Granatelli. It took some chances, like with its swimsuit model issues. And it even took leave of its senses with this centerfold of Grumpy Jenkins. During the past 50 years, Hot Rod's become more than a magazine. It's grassroots racing with its quickest streetcar series. It's a lifestyle experience with its cross-country power tour. And now it's also television, spreading the gearhead gospel to millions of new enthusiasts.
There's never been a magazine that caters to the enthusiast, hardcore, hands-on guy like Hot Rod. I don't know what happened to the time. We were just kids, and now it's been 50 years.
It's been a wonderful 50 years, and Hot Rod thanks you for sharing the ride.
every time you turn a page of Hot Rod. You'll feel the rumble of 400 horses at your feet. You'll smell the nitro burning. You'll see some of the sweetest rides ever. And experience the power of the best articles ever written. Call this 800 number right now and we'll send you a free issue. A free issue when you subscribe to 1 year of the hottest, most exciting Hot Rod magazine anywhere. You'll find everything there is to know about hot rod. Call right now and order 1 year of Hot Rod and reserve your free issue. Then strap yourself in for the ride of your life. Hot Rod. Call now.
They come from all over for the most agonizing test of endurance motorsports has to offer. The heavyweight championship of off-road racing. The legendary Baja 1000. Mile after mile of unforgiving terrain that can send even the toughest truck to an early grave, which means it can really be murder on a battery. That's why more drivers who tackle the Baja rely on the Duralast battery than any other. The same Duralast we stock at AutoZone. The Duralast battery. Power you can depend on.
Following a taste test win over McDonald's fries, Burger King is offering tastier-than-ever twofers. Two orders of crispy new fries, two burgers, just $2.22. Hi, Susie.
Thanks, Steve. Fry fanatics everywhere are excited to see their hero.
I can't hear you.
$2.22.
That's super, Steve. Two fries, two burgers, $2.22.
Told to us tonight by a tuber.
$2.22.
And now, Hot Rod's Hot Parts, brought to you by Restore. Don't be fooled by imitators. Original Engine Restorer brings back lost compression and power. It is America's ultimate engine restorer.
If you've got a 5.7-liter engine in your late-model Chevy or GMC truck, well, here's a way to put a little more pickup in your pickup. Now, since 1987, the General has relied on TBI to meter fuel into those motors. It's a step up from a carburetor, to be sure, but I'll tell you what, it still had some problems with fuel distribution.
Well, Edelbrock's solution is its new Performer multi-point EFI system. Their intake manifold delivers an equal charge to each cylinder while fuel is injected directly into each port. Now, the result is an even air-fuel ratio from cylinder to cylinder for more horsepower, torque, and fuel economy.
Of course, you still retain the use of some of your OE hardware. For instance, your old throttle body becomes an air valve, and your OE computer is reprogrammed to batch fire these injectors. Now, all your other sensors are retained, and they're fully functional. This system is street legal in all 50 states and sells for just under $1,200.
Well, another proven power booster is a set of headers. While the basic design has remained the same for over 30 years, well, here's a new spin on that tubular technology.
These new torque step headers from Hedman start with smaller size tubes at the header flange, then step up in size downstream. This provides two distinctly different torque peaks. The first one you'll feel right off idle. The other one kicks in for upper RPM passing power. Of course, all those tubes are mandrel bent for maximum flow.
Now, the theory of these things is so compelling that we decided to test out a set on our Project Super Sport in a few weeks. Oh, by the way, a set will set you back a couple of $100 with the extra ceramic coating here, an extra buck and a half.
Now, a lot of times when you add power with a set of headers, well, your pipe dreams can turn into a nightmare, especially if you have to ding those tubes for some spark plug clearance or to keep your plug wire boots from burning.
Now Excel has a cure for those hot wire blues, their new high-performance header plugs. As you see here, compared with a standard plug, this new shorty design solves those header clearance problems.
Of course, the best part is they're affordable. They're priced comparably to other high-performance plugs.
Well, that's a look at Hot Parts for now. Now a look at next week's Hot Rod TV.
Head to Michigan for some red-hot highlights as the world's quickest street cars do battle. We'll look back at a monumental motor that powered the hot rod revolution, the Chevy 265 small block. And we'll add some high-tech induction to our classic Camaro project car.
And remember, high-performance fun is what this show is all about.
Let's get this motor over here.
Okay. Hey, doesn't that thing look good with that Chevy orange?
Ooh,
gold?
I'm telling you.
Can't wait to get the headers on.
Just right over here, so you kind of size things up in this Camaro.
All right. Yeah. That's good.
There you go. Yeah, that's pretty good.
Hanson strip pretty nice.
You know, that was a lot of work right there.
Yep. Well, we got a lot of stuff to get to this thing.
Radiator, for sure.
Yeah, radiator.
Motor mount.
That's it. Yes, yes.
So prepare yourself for the bloody mayhem and unholy carnage of Joshua Logan's Paint Your Wagon.
With blood, I bet.
Hey! That's a pretty sorry looking wagon you got there, mister.
I reckon it could use a coat of paint.
Well, what are we waiting for?
Gonna paint our wagon, gonna paint it good. We ain't bragging, we're gonna coat that wood.
We're gonna paint that wagon, we're gonna paint it good.
They're singing, Marge. Why aren't they killing each other?
Yeah, their guns are right there.
Wait. Here comes Lee Marvin. Thank God. He's always drunk and violent.
What the hell is going on in my town?
We're just painting this wagon. You got a problem with that?
As a matter of fact, I do. You missed a spot.
Will, grab a brush and join in.
Gonna paint your wagon, gonna paint it fine. Gonna use oil-based paint, cause the wood is pine.
On your rows of
pine.
Who knew that Lee Marvin could do such marvelous splits? He's dreaming.
Why do they have to screw up a perfectly serviceable wagon story with all that fruity singing?
I thought it was toe-tapping fun.
Singing is the lowest form of communication.
Homer, you sing all the time.
No, I don't. I hate to rhyme.
You like musicals, don't you, Dad?
No, I don't. I think they're bad. They're fake and phony and totally wrong.
Wake up, Dad. You're singing a song.
I wouldn't. I couldn't. I hate that stuff.
Now, Homer, listen. I've had enough. In our family videos, we have plainly seen you're a singing, dancing, entertainment machine.
And a two, and a three.
Boom, 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 baby on board.